Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, on this sacred and solemn day, we remember and we pray. Shortly after Mass, we will go in procession and we will bless the graves of my predecessors, Bishop Waters and Bishop Gossman, as well as the deceased religious and laity who are buried in the cemetery outside. And as we do, we remember them. We remember their faithful example and service, especially as they lived their Catholic faith and proclaimed it to others. And many of them at a time when it was not easy to do. They had courage and they persevered. And so we pray for them. And we pray for their eternal peace. And we pray for the grace that we need to imitate that courage, that faithful example. As we go out in procession, we also remember that we are on an earthly journey. And that no matter how young or old we are, no matter what our vocation in life might be, we all share the same goal, the final destination, to get to heaven and to live with God forever. And so we pray for that grace that in the midst of so many distractions, in the midst of so many demands and responsibilities, we never take our eye off that goal. It's the reason why our saint, whose feast we celebrate today, Charles Borromeo, would say to us, stop all unnecessary chatter. Instead, meditate on God's word. Speak to God often. Keep our eyes fixed on that which is above. And we pray for that grace. Today, we also remember God's promises, so beautifully proclaimed in today's sacred scripture, that we who unite ourselves to the Lord, especially as we unite ourselves to His cross, will come to share in His glory. It is the Lord who, through His own suffering and death and resurrection, has turned our suffering to glory, and even death to life, and has prepared a dwelling place for us. So we pray today that we leave here with a renewed trust in God's promises, our God who is always faithful, so that we continue this earthly journey with its crosses, with its setbacks, with its obstacles, in joyful hope, in knowing the new life that awaits us. And so we pray for the faithful departed, those buried here, as well as our own deceased parents and family members and friends and anyone who has touched and inspired our lives. And how privileged we are to pray for them as we are so closely united to them at this holy sacrifice of the Mass. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.